bring it back. From the Groove Remains production team studios in the Netherlands. My name is Mix Master G and welcome to this live stream. My mission is not to sell you as many apps as I can. No, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs, so you save yourself more time for the fun and creative part of being a DJ. As always, let me quickly introduce myself. I am a 54-year-old dude from the Netherlands, had my first DJ residency at the age of 15. That means you look at almost 40 years of DJ experience in the flesh. And I spend my days these days with sharing the accumulated knowledge of those 40 years with you DJs out there. You may also know me from the DJ Conversion Utility. That is the app that makes it possible to convert between all kind of DJ software, maintaining your cues, loops, grids, etc., etc. And I make tons of other apps. Each Tuesday, I host this very Ask Me Anything live stream, where I will cover some of the subjects that I came around in the past week, questions that I received from DJs, and of course, the chat is open for your very own questions. You can drop them in the chat, and I will try to answer them to the best of my abilities and maybe demonstrate how certain things can be done. Before we move on, let's quickly say hi to the people in the chat. First of all, AG Breakfast Connector, he was the first one out there today. Welcome to the stream, my friend. Good to see you. Marcus Marco, hello, salute. And I really like the little Halloween emoticon you got there. El Bougie, welcome to the chat and welcome to the stream, my friend. This has been a busy week, my friends. A very busy week, and I didn't expect it to be busy. Actually, when I finished the stream last week, I thought, all right, this is going to be kind of a quiet week because Apple released Monterey. I'm going to spend the rest of the week testing everything on Monterey, see how it holds up, see if it works. And see how that all works. So that was actually my intention. And then at Thursday, Friday, all hell broke loose. My mailbox started accumulating lots and lots and lots of DJs who were kind of in distress because all of a sudden their record box didn't start up anymore. And that was really a big issue because last weekend was Halloween weekend, which is amongst one of the most important weekends in DJ history, one of the most busiest, together with, for instance, New Year and the holidays. I think it is amongst the busiest. And all of a sudden, their record box didn't work anymore. And I can imagine that is a problem if you have gigs for that weekend. So I started to talk to some of those DJs to see what was going on, because by that time most normal support channels were already closed, so little old me was the only one available to at least ask questions about why that Rekordbox was not working. And I started to investigate, and it turned out that I found the reason why stuff was not working anymore, because all those DJs had one particular thing in common, and that was, let me show that, this little thingy. They all installed the macOS Catalina 10.15.7 security update 007. Now, usually those security updates are low profile, they are low impact, they just tweak some stuff within the macOS, and that is about it. However, all these DJs whose Rekordbox didn't work anymore all had in common that they installed this particular update and it didn't work anymore. So I had to see if I could come up with a solution. Even this is not my problem. I claim to help any DJ with macOS tech questions I can. So I had to live up to that name. So I started to investigate. First of all, I installed this particular update to my very own computers. I actually have a few computers running Catalina. And when I installed that update, there was no problem. Everything was working. Rekordbox was working just fine. I could start it up. Everything was working fine. So there was something else besides this particular update that they all run that was causing it. And mind you, this was for both Rekordbox 5 and Rekordbox 6. It really didn't matter which Rekordbox version. What I didn't check, and if somebody is watching this with this particular problem, if Rekordbox 5.6.0 has this problem, because I can imagine that 5.6.0 doesn't have this particular problem. It might not crash. However, most DJs were either on Rekordbox 6 or on 5.8.6, and those crashed immediately after this update on their machines. So I started to investigate what those DJs all had in common, because it were mostly MacBook Pros, and it were 13-inch and 15-inch MacBook Pros, and some had i5s and some had i7s. So I started to collect just as many, because it was really, my inbox was really full with DJs with this particular problem. So I really could dig very easily. All right, guys, tell me, what are the exact specifications of your Mac? Give me the exact Apple model number. So not the number like it's a MacBook Pro 2012. 13-inch, that is not enough. I want to have the specific model number. And they all gave me their model number, so I dove a little bit more deep, and I came to the conclusion that most of them were this Mac. And let me get that on the screen as well, because these days I try to switch my screen if I can. Let's see if that works. There we are. As you can see, this is the Mac, this is the 13-inch, but others were 15-inch. But what was important that everything had in common was this, the graphic and video support, the Intel HD 4000. Now, mind you, the Intel HD 4000 is what we call an integrated graphical processor, which means that it is not something that AMD built or something that NVIDIA builds. No, it is built inside the CPU, inside the Intel CPU, on actually the same chip. It usually uses the same RAM memory as the CPU does. In this case, it doesn't do it. They call that shared RAM memory. And that IGP, that particular IGP, the Intel HD Graphics 4000, is what everybody was running. So that at least gave me some more clue, because all my computers are not using IGPs. They are all using what is known as discrete graphic processors, which means big cards, video cards, usually AMD RX 580s, if you are interested in that kind of stuff, which means I didn't have that problem. But everything with an Intel HD Graphic 4000 GPU was having that issue. So I started to dig a little bit deeper and came up with what is known as the release notes. And in the release notes of the Catalina 007 security update, mind you, that is the update we are talking about. You can see it right there. This is the update we are talking about. And these are the release notes of that update. Now, in this release notes, you always can see, all right, what did I change? What did I change? This is not interesting. This is not interesting. Now, here things start to get interesting. Core graphics. Those core graphics were done, all right. File provider is not interesting. But here, Intel graphics driver. Hey, Intel graphics driver. IGP, integrated graphic processor. That might be a thing, that might be a problem. And you can read that they now prevented something from memory corruptions and multiple out-of-bounds write issues. That all sounds very technical, but basically it comes down to they found some exploits, some bugs within that IGP, or not actually in the IGP, I go into details a little bit later, but they found some bugs that when an application, a random application, talks to the graphics processor, all of a sudden things could go wrong and the system would throw an error. And they wanted to prevent that, so they made some tweaks, and that is what is part of that 007 security release update. Long story short, if you need to understand a little bit how macOS graphics work. And in macOS, we have something as that is called the OpenGL layer. OpenGL is a uniform way for an application to talk to the OS, either Windows, Unix, macOS, to tell it to draw something on screen. And the OS takes it over and then divert that specific instruction to either hardware, software, or a combination of both. OpenGL was introduced or was actually developed by Silicon Graphics back in the early 90s. Silicon Graphics was one of the very early computer companies that made computer graphic imagery possible, or computer generated imagery, CGI, possible. For instance, movies like Jurassic Park are entirely based on Silicon Graphic computers processing that. It is old technology, but it still works, and it is open technology. Everybody uses it. And because it's universal, because you just as an application developer need to talk to the OpenGL layer, and OpenGL takes care of the rest, that means you have optimum performance of any hardware that is inside. Long story short, usually when you want to do video stuff and you use the CPU for that, the CPU gets slowed down, and the CPU for us DJs has other stuff to do as well. It has to calculate audio, it has to resample stuff, it might have to do some file sharing, talk to the Wi-Fi. It has a lot of tasks besides putting stuff on screen. That is why you want to offload that very intense, those very intense calculations to a GPU, just to make sure that the CPU doesn't need to handle that kind of stuff. That's something that is specialized for it and much more equipped for it, can handle that. So, in short, what I needed to do was disabling OpenGL. But basically, that is not something you want to do. Because if you disable OpenGL, either the CPU takes over and does all the calculations to put stuff on your screen, which is okay if you have a very powerful computer. But these were all old computers. These are from 2012, 2013 that has this IGP. So you really don't want to disable it altogether. If you disable it, everything is calculated by the CPU, so things get stuttering on the screen. And for instance, as some found out the hard way, karaoke and video playback didn't work at all in Rekordbox anymore. Lucky for us, I found another parameter in the Rekordbox settings file, which tweaked the way that Rekordbox talks to OpenGL, but still keeps it enabled. Which means that everything still works and it kind of circumvents the bug. How to do that? I made a video about it. It is in the YouTube channel. It is kind of trending for my mics right now. So look that up if you have a Mac that meet those specifications. And those specifications are, first of all, you need to be on macOS Catalina. Second of all, you need to have installed that macOS security update 007. That is this one. And then third of all, you need to have a macOS computer that is equipped with the Intel HD Graphics 4000 card. If you meet those three criteria and your Rekordbox doesn't start up anymore, then watch that video, because I talk in that video how you can fix it. Now, mind you, nothing in this world is entirely perfect. So it is possible that there are still DJs whose Rekordbox crashes at startup. That most likely means that they are not suffering from this issue alone, but maybe something else as well. So that should have some more needs some more finding out, and talk to Pioneer about that, because I like to help DJs out, but that means a lot of DJs must have the similar issue, because you cannot expect me to be the second tier or the first tier support for Pioneer DJ. They have their own perfect support who can help you. However, like this weekend, which is a special weekend, and I hear so many DJs having issues, then I jump in and I try to do whatever I can to get it going. So that was kind of a special situation. But you can always reach out to me, because if things are simple to fix or simple to work around, then I'm always happy to share the knowledge if I have that knowledge. So it's not that I don't want to. It's more like that I'm just a one-man band and I have one thing I can do. So look into that. Another important thing, most likely it's not only Rekordbox that has this issue on computers that meet those three criteria. I heard already DJs who used Virtual DJ that had issues on these configurations. I heard from someone who was trying to use Mixed in Key that couldn't use it anymore. So I think this release has further implications than just Rekordbox, but because Rekordbox is used by the vast majority of DJs, that is the first thing that jumps out the moment that things breaks down like that. And lucky for us, it is at the beginning of Rekordbox. You cannot even start it up. I personally find it much more worse if programs just quit halfway or crash halfway, because that's far more frustrating. You never know if it's going to happen, when it's going to happen, and how it's going to happen. So I like kind of the simplicity that it will always crash at startup, because that means you can fix it instead of, no, you have to play that track first and that track first, and if I then use that effect and then make it that wet and then it will crash. That is hard to kind of mimic. So I give me problems that are reproducible, and then I love to fix them. Talking about fixing things, Apple came out with Monterey last week, and I already announced it in the stream that I was going to play with it. I did that as well. And my final report is everything works. So I can show it. I can say, all right, look, this works, that works, but that is boring as hell. I always like to show stuff that doesn't work and then tell you how to fix it. But on macOS Monterey, everything works. Now, mind you, if I say everything works, I mean everything works software-wise, which means Serato will work, Rekordbox will work, Traktor will work, Mixing Key will work, Engine DJ will work, my tools all work. However, I didn't try it with any specific hardware or with any specific controllers, and it might as well be possible that your specific controller does not work on Monterey because the drivers were not updated. I already said this a few times, but I'm going to repeat myself. Rule of thumb: if you are currently on Big Sur, then Monterey will be fine for you. Then you don't need to expect any problems with upgrading to Monterey. But again, and I cannot repeat that enough, if you are not forced to update, if your mission critical apps don't require you to update, and you don't really need those new features of the OS, then why would you update in the first place? Then your current OS is just as fine. And that is also the message I gave to those people who are running into those problems with those HD graphic cards. By running Catalina on such an old hardware, you are talking about 9-year-old hardware. Why using a recent OS on that? Just run Hysera on it and everything will run smoothly and fine. There is really no reason to go that high. And mind you, the 2012 MacBook Pros are amongst the most favorite ones with DJs because they still got all the USB ports. They still got a full HDMI port and they are fast enough to run every DJ software you throw at it. So it really are workhorses. So don't upgrade them. Don't do that. You don't need to. There is no need to run Catalina on those things. Run Catalina on your administration computer or something, but not on your DJ computer. That's just not a bright idea. So let me put that little toilet tile that I always have in the screen once more. This one that is. And please, 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 folks, live by this. It is so important and it can save you so much frustrations. Don't update if you don't really, really, really need to update. And I see that the little typo is still in this one, so I need to put the new one in here. But hey, that's just me. All right, folks. This was actually all I wanted to discuss in this stream or had prepared for this stream to discuss, which means the chat is wide open for each and every question you guys might have, and I'm very happy to answer those or to demonstrate to you how stuff is going to be done. In all fairness, I still got a sour feet. I think I'm going to the doctor tomorrow to check out what might be happening with it. So I'm not sure if I'm making this a very long one. Unless there are questions, of course, because then I try to answer those questions. Let me say hi to some more people here. Jipanate, welcome to the show, my friend, and hello to you as well. Then we got Tito Morales. Hello, Mixmaster G. DJ Salso here. Greetings. More than welcome, my friend, and greetings back. Eddie Broom, as always, a little bit late, what I used, but good to see your face in here, my friend, in the stream. And Tito Morales, thank you for that great information and making me smarter. Well, that is exactly what I hope to do, Tito. And the thing is, I understand that this stuff can get nerdy, because first of all, I am a tech nerd, so I think technical. And second of all, that is the whole reason that I do this stream, just to try to make you guys understand what is going on behind the scenes. So in case of emergencies, in case of problems, you have a little bit of an idea where you can find the solution to that problem, because most things are solvable, but you need to know where to look at. And that is again why I do these streams and what I try to educate in these streams. Peeps, no questions today. That means this is going to be a short, very short live stream, which, like I said, is okay with me. But if there are questions or if there are stuff that you want to know from me, then drop it in the chat and I'm happy to answer that. Matt Positive, yo, Mixmaster G. Greetings from Chicago. Not thinking about updating, but wondering if the iTunes Music to Rekordbox playlist import process works as expected in Monterey. Yes, Matt, it does. And that means you basically still got the two options there. Let me show those two options. You know what? Let me turn up my Monterey machine and then I have to be a little bit careful because I need to use my stick. Like I said, I really have that sour feet, so I feel a little bit like I am disabled. I'm going to start up my Mac Mini, which will take a little moment, and then I have to make sure that I can TeamViewer in it, and then we are going to answer Mac Positive's friend question, namely, how is the integration of the music app of Monterey together with Rekordbox. But like I said, give me a little second because this Mac Mini needs to start up and then maybe I need to throw some stuff from it that are not for everybody's eyes. Now I get a totally noisy screen. There we are. Hold on, folks. I should have prepared this kind of stuff, right? This and that and that. That can go. That can go. that can go. Let's eject that one. Won't eject, which is annoying. Why not? Eject the drive. Okay, two. All right. Looks like I am up and running. TeamViewer is still starting up. But Matt, I think I can go to my Mac Mini from my normal computer. So let me walk back. Usually I like the space that I have in my studio, but sometimes it is just annoying as hell that I have to walk back and forth. Mo Berry, my friend, in the house. Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Let's see. Let me first see that I can TeamViewer into my Mac Mini. Alrighty. There, that's there. Now let me switch the screens. Like this. And I made, as you can see, I made my... Not what I want to do. I can now move that around. Isn't that sweet? All right, this is Monterey. And you cannot see the background because I have that switched off. But as you can see, macOS Monterey. And Matt Positive asks, all right, how is the music app working with Rekordbox? So here we go. We've got the music app and let's give it a test playlist. And then let's put some. I think I throw away some of my test tracks, but that's okay. And I think that I don't have the correct. Oh damn, I'm good. Always have that off, people. I cannot repeat that enough. Make sure you don't let iTunes or the music app copy your tracks, because if it does, then you can get into problems. Why is that? It's annoying. It looks like TeamViewer and the magnification thingy, you see that in the middle, don't like each other. I mean, go into TeamViewer again, see if I can get that right again, if it will go. No, it doesn't go away at all. Oh, that's not annoying at all. Let's see if I can turn that off, because we don't want to have zoomed in the middle, because that really can drive you crazy. Don't let me. I'm so used. No idea why it's not doing what I want it to do. And then I want it to shut down. And that it doesn't. I don't know. Hold on, folks, because this is annoying as hell. Where's my team viewer? There's my team viewer. Quit it. Let's log out and log in. And let's not use the magnification. And you can bet that I'm going to use the magnification again. So be prepared for that. I know myself. All right, that's cleared up. I need to sign into my TeamViewer computer again. I can make my way back. Here we are. Hello, everybody. That's better. Okay. Let's hide this one. Okay. So back to the music app. And let's see that we have the test playlist. As you can see, the test playlist is there, is right there. View as songs, please. why don't you guys make that the default thing? Now I am faced with the option to export the library to XML. Not going to do that. Let's try first what happens if we are going through the framework, which is what Apple wants to push ahead to use and which I really don't like to use at all. Let's wait a little bit. Let's see what else we got. All right, let's see what we can do. We go to the advanced and we go to the library syncs. No, not that one, to the others. It's also fine to the database. And you can see that it's set to framework. I'm not going to, but right here, I'm not going to zoom it in because otherwise we get that sticky zoom again. So that means that it should already be there. So let's have a look, shall we? Let's have a look. And indeed, that is already there. Now, if I go to my and remove that playlist, and we made the stream test playlist, and then let's open the Finder and let's add some more tracks to it. In downloads, I think I have some test tracks here. You see here. Oh, that's the same. Like this. And then we go back here. Always, by the way, quit music if you do this stuff like this, because if you don't quit it, then not all the changes are automatically communicated through all the apps and throughout the framework. So quit music. Then let's simply refresh here. There you can see that stream test. So met positive, you see this is working fine. Now for the real connoisseurs amongst us, like myself, let's try the XML method. So export the library to XML. Mind you, you need to do this every time something changes in music, and let's put it just in a place that you can easily find it. Create into music. Now if I go to Rekordbox and if I say right here under iTunes XML and then browse it. So it uses the one I just exported, which is on the music. Where am I? There it is. Well, there. This is the one. Let's open it. And there you can see it already. Now to show you that indeed this is now coming from the XML, go to it again. Let's say stream test 1, 2, 3. Again, if I change something, I need to export it again to XML. So export the complete library to XML. I leave everything default so I don't have to point it again, replace it. That's just fine, mister. And let's say refresh. And there you see, test 1, 2, 3. So that is coming in just fine. So both XML and framework are working fine, met positive, no problems there. All right, the next one, Tito Mortalis has a question. Let me get back to my normal cram. Have a MacBook Pro 15 Retina. Do you think eventually Apple will force me to upgrade to the next OS? Apple will always try to force you to upgrade or will strongly try to upgrade you, but there is never a need to upgrade. So you can always say turn off your auto updates and that will be fine. So that is actually what I suggest you will do. Just turn off auto upgrade because there is no reason. The only things that can force you to upgrade are the software, the applications that you use. For instance, Rekordbox can say, all right, we only work from Catalina up instead of from High Sierra up. So then you are forced to upgrade. But right now, and besides that, Apple will never force an Intel-based computer to upgrade because they are now working on the M1 and they keep Intel compatibility alive, backward compatibility, we call that alive, for just a few more years. But trust me, within 4 years, that MacBook will be useless as far as the latest OS goes, but will still be very useful as far as a DJ computer, because it will still just work fine. So don't update if you don't need to. Albuji 3, here we go. I got Mixed in Key and followed the video from Mixed in Key to integrate it into Rekordbox. Now the key for songs is not numerical, even if it's set to be inside Rekordbox. Is there an easy way to get Rekordbox to see the hotcues that Mixed in Key set for tracks? Of course there is. And that is called the Rekordbox Cue and Key tool, and that is a little tool I developed. And it works beautiful, and it integrates, it does a lot of things, but its main purpose is to integrate data from Mixed in Key with Rekordbox. But again, it is not just as simple as it takes the data from Mixed in Key. It does a lot of things. It can add Mixed in Key cues to your existing cues. It can remove Mixed in Key cues. It can set the command field you want to, any way you want to. So let me quickly show you how that works, because it isn't that complicated anymore. Actually, it became pretty simple with the latest update. Let me fire up a Rekordbox here. Give it a little bit of time. I had some really great dinner, but very salty. And usually I fast on Tuesday, so then I don't eat at all. So, but today I did eat, and I'm a little bit thirsty, as you can see. So excuse me for that. All right, here we've got a Rekordbox collection. Let me set all the keys to none, or to geen. That is Dutch for none. I set the commands to geen, also Dutch for none. So I don't have keys, I don't have commands. Now I don't know, most is not analyzed. So let me analyze some of those tracks. Let's see if that works. Those tracks can be found at all. Yeah, they can be found, as you can see. So those are being analyzed. Then let me fire up at the same time Mixed in Key. And let's make sure that all my preferences are switched off. And that is very important, folks. So everything, you see update tags, switched off. Export cue points, we don't do that. Rename files, never rename files. Stuff like that. Keynotation, Camelot, very important, everything off. So you might think, hey, Mixmaster G, but then nothing will happen. Watch and learn. So let's throw those tracks inside the Mixed in Key collection. Now mind you, I did not analyze all the tracks, and mind you, I did not put all the tracks into Mixed in Key. And I did that on purpose. And you will see in a moment why I did that on purpose. Let me quit Rekordbox here. Let's see, Mixed in Key is almost done. Is done with the analysis. Mixed in Key, people, Yakov, please give me back the status bar where I can see the count of what is being analyzed. It's much easier to find. I will email you about it, buddy, because still get problems with that. And let me fire up the Rekordbox Cue and Key tool. And that is that tool that is made, like I said, for the integration of Mixed in Key and Rekordbox data. And I didn't give it all the proper permissions, so you don't see it. It's off screen now, but let's hope it is the latest version, because I did roll out updates for all my apps over the weekend, as most of you have seen. That is for Monterey compatibility. Actually, there was an annoying pop-up in Monterey that said that my tools needed to be updated. And I really didn't like that, so I got rid of that particular message. And that is where all the ATGR tools are updated. We are going direct to 8. And now, watch this, Albuji. Watch this very closely. I'm not doing anything. I'm not exporting any Rekordbox XMLs. I'm not going to import anything. The only thing I say is start conversion. All my settings are correct. I want to merge Mixed in Key cues with the existing cues. I want my command to be key, BPM, and energy level. And that's basically it. There's much more possible, but this is basically just the start. Just sit back. Wait a moment. it's already done. And mind you, no XML import, no reloading tags, nothing, nothing, nothing. You can already see it. But let me show that a little bit better. There we are. With the mixing key cues both set as hot cue and as memory cue, the little numbers you see there between brackets means the energy level that the cue is pointing to. And if you look now at the key, you see that the keys are there. If you look at the command fields, then you see that the command fields are sorted the way I want them to be. You see that? So you can sort on command now. Really, really, really very convenient. Now I told you I did not analyze all the tracks. I told you I did not put all the tracks in mixing key. And you see that the Rekordbox Cue and Key tool made its own folder. And there it tells you these tracks didn't need to be analyzed in mixing key. Or actually, they don't have a key. These tracks were processed. These tracks didn't have any grid. They were not analyzed in Rekordbox, and that is very important. So you can just grab them and say, all right, analyze those tracks. Let's go. And they will be analyzed. And these tracks were not found in mixing key. They need to be added to mixing key. And that is why those folders are there. And that is what makes life very easy, because you know exactly what you need to do. So I can now take all those tracks and just throw them into mixing key as well. And then wait for them to be processed. And then run rack again, and it will get all the data there. As you can see, nothing to it. It doesn't get much easier than this. And most of all, it doesn't get much faster than this. This is so much faster than exporting XMLs, importing XML, stuff like that. So get your own license of rack. It's not very expensive. Will save you a lot of time and a whole lot of frustrations. That's for sure. Let's go. Oh, and there's an update available, as you can see. Let's do that again. As you can see, this is really, really fast. If you ever imported XML information into a big database, into a big existing Rekordbox database, that can take ages. Not this. This is very, very fast, as you can see. Right now you only have process tracks, because everything else could be found, and you can see that everything is there. So that's it, my friends. Doesn't get any easier than that. All right, what else do I have on the question part? Is there any easier way? Yeah, there is. Then Tito Mortales says that is about Apple trying to force you to update. They indeed always do. It looks outside, dark outside. What local time is it? It is right now 7:45, quarter to 8 in the PM. It's already dark because we are now on daylight saving. So that means it gets light an hour earlier than usually, and it gets dark an hour earlier than usually. And normally the windows behind me have blinds at the outside that I lower, but because it's already dark outside, I don't need to lower the blinds. So the blinds are not down, so you might see the occasional car light passing by or something. That gives a little bit of a lively feeling. VDJ Soul. Hey, my virtual DJ is freezing and crashing on my i5 9th generation 8GB GTX 1650, but Rekordbox 5 with video works flawlessly. Upon hitting the VDJ support, they say VDJ uses more resources than RB. That is not entirely true. Rekordbox, it depends on the Rekordbox version. But Rekordbox Fast version 5.6 uses much more resources than Virtual DJ does. But you have to excuse me, I am really a macOS guy. And those specs you gave me are typical Windows specs, so I'm afraid I really cannot help you otherwise, other than saying Rekordbox is by far the most resource-hungry DJ app out there. Traktor and Virtual DJ actually are very light, relatively light on resources they require. So I'm not sure why they're saying that to you, but the specs you gave me doesn't sound like a computer that shouldn't be capable of running video. That should run just smooth, and VDJ is made for that kind of stuff. So that should just go fine. Yeah, 16 gig, 8 gig is fine. 8 gig should be fine, but 16 more is always better. With RAM, more is always better. Jesus, that. Mulberry asks, my 2011 MacBook Pro is running High Sierra. Is that OS a good fit for Serato and OBS? Sure it is. However, remember that OBS and macOS are not really friends. I am running macOS on my computer right here, which is an i9 computer with a GPU, a separate discrete GPU card. I'm running an AMD RX 580 as the GPU in it. That cannot be utilized by OBS, by the way. But the actual upload of the stream going through the various, actually going to restream and then restream distributing it over Facebook, YouTube and Twitch, is handled by a different computer. So this computer I'm working on, my DJ computer, my basically my office computer, the computer I always work on, is connected over Ethernet, so with wire, to another computer that is handling the upload of the stream to offload this computer. Especially with an older MacBook like you are mentioning, High Sierra is great for that computer. So don't ever go further than that. High Sierra is great for that computer. But if you want to run OBS, I would seriously suggest that you look if you can connect that computer to another computer and then let that other computer handle OBS, because that might be a little bit too much, especially if you use OBS to upload. If it is for recording, then it might do the job, because that is not as resource intensive. But the moment you can watch the actual meter in the corner of OBS and see how much it's taking for that. VDJ, so optimize my Windows laptop as much as possible. Battery, do know what to do. No, my friend, I really don't know what to do either. Like I said, I am not a Windows man. I am a macOS man. But it doesn't sound like you are low on resources there. It sounds like that should work just fine. So maybe something else is at play. What I could suggest to you is just test it with Serato. Just see what Serato does. That also is really resource intensive, and if that works fine too, then you can really say, all right, there is something not completely correct in my VDJ configuration. Maybe some hardware graphics accelerators that needs to be enabled. Maybe that VDJ is not taking advantage of that NVIDIA card you have inside. Stuff like that. So look there. Matt Positive, nice framework versus XML was my first follow-up question. Well, Matt, you got it all covered, my friend. It is working. And it is all working as expected. Elbow is chiming in as well. And I always liked it if people in the chat are helping each other, because I try to build a little bit of a community here, folks. So always try to help each other. But again, VDJ is not a resource hog, so I don't see the problem there. Let's see, lockdown, I used with videos, OBS, Yellow Duck, Chrome simultaneously for my live stream. Never had a problem. No, that's one of the benefits of a Windows computer over a macOS computer. You have a discrete graphics card, you have that NVIDIA card inside there. And Windows is tailored to use that card for whatever graphic stuff is going on your screen. So your CPU and your RAM is your memory is actually not used that intensive. Everything is offloaded to the GPU and calculated there. And that is the way it should be. I wish we had more of that technology in macOS. Right now, things start to look like that with the M1 chips. However, in order to take advantage of the GPU of an M1 chip, applications need to be compiled in a certain way, which means that they usually lose backward compatibility. So developers are a little bit reluctant in adopting that technology yet. It will come, but it will get there very, very slowly. Eddie Brom, I have a 2012 Pro model. I am unable to upgrade this beyond Catalina. Yeah, you are, and I wouldn't put it on Catalina at all. I will stay on High Sierra, as I previously have mentioned in this in this stream, because that was one of the trouble MacBook Pros with the Catalina 007 security update. Elbucci, yeah, I know you're not using an Apple laptop. Let's see what else we got. VJ and Elbucci. And Mixmagi, I wish that program was for Windows also. I'll pay you to make for it. Oh, you are on the, all right, you cannot use the Rekordbox Cue and Key tool. Sorry for that, folk. Like I mentioned in almost all of my streams, I am macOS only, and that is not because I'm an OS snob. It is simply because I know everything about macOS there is to know about it, and I don't know that much about Windows. And most questions I receive are not Apple related, they are OS related, and I cannot fix those support questions for Windows, and I'm not going to outsource that. I'm not going to give my IP away to someone else who says I can do this better and then not doing it at all. If they are as good as they say they are, then they can develop my apps themselves as well, because it's not that hard. I did it too. So that's that. I have a second question, maybe bigger and messier question. Have the energy? Yes, sure, Matt Positives. Yes, shoot it. And we try to do whatever we can. So drop it in. Earl Whiff, salute. Salute, Mixmaster GNL. Or does it have a salute? This is a great day. I have my rig working as required. Finally, you know that feeling. Yeah, I know exactly that feeling. That is always a great feeling. I like to build my own computers. And then when finally everything is working the way you expect it to work, that is indeed a great feeling. All right, the big messy question from Matt Positive. Here we go. Rekordbox Dropbox Pro team problems. Basically, I split my Rekordbox audio files between multiple Dropbox folders on two different computers. Yeah. No single instance of RB can access all the files, though. The XML seems intact, since I'm using RB to backup the XML to the cloud versus locally. But feel free to pass on this question. I might just consolidate files, then manage in iTunes and slowly rebuild. Not entirely sure what you mean by there, Matt Positive. You mean you have one Rekordbox Pro account, you have two computers, and those two computers have entirely different collections. Is that what you mean? Can you confirm that? Because if that is the case, then you are out of luck, because that whole Rekordbox Pro synchronization is based on the fact that you have this one huge collection, which is similar across all your devices and being rolled out on all your devices. And then it doesn't, once it is the same on all your devices, then it really doesn't matter where you add tracks, because you add tracks on computer A, that syncs it back to the cloud. You start up computer B, that sees, hey, there's stuff changed in the cloud, and syncs back, and then computer B and computer A will be the same again. But multiple Dropbox folders, no, that will not work. Yeah, I think with things like that, the only thing that you can do is really start from scratch, really start with a clean slate, because otherwise it will just stack up. I've never seen that happen, by the way. I use Dropbox not for Rekordbox. I don't like the way Rekordbox integrated that stuff. But Dropbox itself works great, and you can use it with my tools, of course, which works just fine. And I like how Denon Prime did the Dropbox integration. However, I have this feeling that something is brewing inside Pioneer that will show us the real thing they had in mind with Dropbox. So maybe we have to hold up for a little bit to see what they really want Dropbox to be. But the way it is implemented right now, no, it's not my cup of tea yet. I can see the library data on Rekordbox from each computer. but do not have access to the actual files. Yes, do you have the pro account there, Matt? Or do you have just the normal account there? Do you have that with the unlimited Dropbox data? And did you create a new Dropbox account for that? And did you enter that Dropbox account into everything? Because I haven't played with the pro thing yet in Rekordbox. I have asked Pioneer to get me a partner subscription because I really don't need this stuff. And I'm for sure not going to pay $30 just to test this out and to be a second tier of support for them. So if they want me to support that, then they can pay for my subscription. So I really don't know how that works, but I understood that the pro account doesn't use the sync manager anymore for Dropbox, but that it has its very own sync capability and puts things automatically to the cloud. But again, I'm not entirely sure because I don't have first-hand experience in this. If I want, there you go again. If I want to support this kind of stuff, then I have to be played with it. I have to break it. I have to see if I can fix it again. And then I know it. And that's not the case yet. DJ Services Cornwell, would you agree? I'm looking for to upgrade my 2014-15 inch laptop. Is the latest 2021 MacBook M1 Pro the best option for running Rekordbox? That depends, Al. You only want to run Rekordbox on it. And is that Rekordbox with video or Rekordbox without video? What kind of controller do you want to use? Do you expect to use it in clubs, in a DJ Pro Link network? So with CDJs, HIT controlled or UTP controlled. But in general, everything you buy right now will be good enough. Actually, I'm not sure what kind of 2014-15 inch laptop you're talking about, but if that is 2014 MacBook Pro, it should be perfectly be capable of running a Rekordbox right now without any issues. However, you might want to upgrade it to Mojave. And Mojave is my top macOS that I recommend to everybody. After Mojave, Catalina, they dropped 32-bit app support, and that means that not all the plugins and not all the apps will work anymore. But on Mojave, everything should be fine, all drivers will work, so that laptop should be fine. I need to have a little bit more info, of course, but if that is a MacBook Pro, and if it's running an i5 or i7, and if it got at least 8 GB, then you should be good to go with that laptop as well. But new is always nicer, of course. I know. I know the feeling. I'm very guilty of that as well. Pro account, Rekordbox DJ Team account. This all started when I upgraded to Pro. Yeah. I think, Matt Positive, that has to do with the fact that Pro DJ account is not necessarily using the Dropbox sync manager. But again, I could be wrong, so check that out. But I think it might be in that particular thing. RX2, no video. Oh, if the RX2 is your controller, then that laptop, if it's a MacBook Pro, should be more than enough to run a Rekordbox. But again, new is always better. But for just running an RX2, even the MacBook Air would be perfect. And I really, really like MacBook Airs. I use MacBook Airs myself. If I'm on traveling, I use a MacBook Air for two basic reasons. The first reason is the battery lasts forever. You get very long going on the battery. And then I hear a lot of people say, yeah, but Mixmaster G, the internal drive of that particular MacBook Pro is so small, or MacBook Air is so small. And for that, we've got external drives. And let me get my external drive, because then I can show you how I use it, because that's the most interesting part. Because that trick can save you a lot of money. External drive. This is basically a backup of my entire file server with all the tracks that I have in all my collections on it. And here we've got my MacBook Pro. And right here you see this black strip? That's Velcro. And I can just snap this on it. There you go. You don't forget your external drive. You just have a short lead that you run to the USB and it's connected. And if you don't need it, then you don't need it. You take it off. But this is how I usually travel. And you can do as much as you can. Actually, this is called the Afrojack method. I saw Nick doing this with his Windows laptop, and Nick really had a stack of stuff on it. He had a USB hub on it. This was really, really nuts. I told him that was really crazy. But this, just the drive on it using Velcro, great idea. I can recommend that to everybody. So do the best you can do with it. That back too. Let's see what else we got, because I saw Erwiv just bought a Behringer DDM 4000. I'm now able to have fun learning MIDI use. Remapping has been so simple in Serato to the mixer. I'm sure I shall have questions forthcoming. I am not your mapping king. I can map, by the way, pretty good on Traktor, because I used, when I started out on Traktor, all we had were MIDI controllers, and there were no real jog wheel controllers and stuff like that, because that didn't exist back in those days. But glad you got it. And yeah, it is fun to MIDI map that stuff and to make it your own. I still use, for instance, these ones. Let me take one of them. These are really great. They are called Korg Nano Pads. You could see me grab it from behind the 12 behind me. That is my DVS rig behind me. And as you can see, it got this little touchpad. It got 16 real pads on it, and you can change the program on it. So usually I use the top row to set cues and the second row to delete cues. And then you can just set cues the way you want it. And that's all MIDI mapped by myself, and pretty easy to MIDI map in Traktor. Same with keyboard commands and stuff like that. You can do that in Traktor very easy. I'm not really sure how to do it in Serato, but glad that you have that playing. When I signed up for Rekordbox Pro, it made me set up a new database account. Couldn't use my existing account. Yeah, I was afraid of that. I was afraid that might be the case, but not much you can do about it, LBG. I think your only shot is here just to start from scratch with that new account. Make it empty first. Empty it first before you start. Or maybe just throw it away, throw the master away, so that Rekordbox, let me show that. So if you go press the Alt key or the Option key on your keyboard, then you can go to library and then dive into the Pioneer folder. There you've got the Rekordbox folder, and here we've got the master database. Now if you rename this to master one database, then Rekordbox will start to complain when I start it up and will say, hey, I cannot find it. Do you want me to start with an empty one? You see, there we go, converting your library. I don't want to convert, I want to have an empty library. But the good part is that all my settings are still there. So this will basically just, there you go, an empty collection, and then sync it with record. Because if you do this kind of stuff, and we empty this one stuff too, the bloat tracks from collection, there we go. And then you need to wait and to make sure that all this information is synced to Dropbox, so that Dropbox is not still keeping some of the old database, but also that, and then you are basically set to go. DJ Service Cornell, more than welcome, always more than welcome. Trying to share knowledge here. Velcro is really, really, really your help here, Erwiv. I cannot sum up the things I fixed with Velcro and duct tape. So duct tape is, by the way, always part of my DJ bag. I always have duct tape in there. And by the way, I'm a private pilot too, of my pilot bag as well. I just always have duct tape with me because it saved me on so many occasions. So something you want to check out there. People, that looked like a lot of questions. That doesn't mean that I'm through. If you still got questions, then I'm here to help you guys and to answer whatever I can. But just let me know right now, if you've got questions, just say, I still got a question, and then take your time to type it out, because otherwise I'm going to close out the stream for this week, and I hope to see you guys all next week. And it's always a mystery. I fly ultralight and I fly microlight planes. I've got my PPL license, so single engine pistons, but I like to, I'm a very big guy. I am like 6'4". But I like to fly simple planes. I like the simplicity of that. So that is what I fly. I'm no way a commercial pilot, commercial airline pilot. I'm just a private pilot with a single engine piston license. And I want to keep it that way. Again, if there are questions, feel free to drop them in the chat. If not, then we are going to close out for today and next week. We see what next week will bring in terms. For a drone part. I have tried that, Albuji. I've tried to play because everything with wings and everything that can fly always intrigues me. So I played a little bit with drones. But if you are used to. All right. If you are used to fly real planes, then you miss the feeling. So I always miss. I try to fly RC as well. And one of the good things is that we are used to make small movements on jokes, because that is what we are used. Normally, novices with RCs, they are just putting the joke all around as a pilot, you know, to make small movements. But I am not good in that kind of stuff. Hey, Marcus, Macau. More than welcome, and good to have you in the stream, my friend. Hope to see you all next week. My friend, we are going to close out for this week. If you have questions coming up this week, then please leave them in the comments right below the video, and maybe next week I can answer them. You always know where to find me, on either Facebook or by email, if you've got questions, and always good to help you guys out or with. Thank you for being here. If you like what I'm doing, then don't forget to give this video the thumbs up and tell your DJ friends that this information and this service is out there for every DJ to join in and to take advantage of, because all I try to do is just to spread the knowledge and to help as many people as possible. More than welcome, Matt Positive. People, we are going to see who